Now, the most accurate weather forecast in South Texas with meteorologist Juan Acuña.
Hi everyone, welcome back and a very good Friday afternoon to you. We've made it to the end of the week and I wish we had a better sky cam to show you there, but the clouds have returned. We're looking and taking a live look at our one shoreline camera and looking over towards the Harbor Bridge, and the clouds are beginning to blanket us once again, and that's going to be a common theme as we head on into the weekend. Our Nissan Automotive 6 weather bug off in Kingsville. You can see the sunshine early in the day. That was certainly nice to start off the day. And then the blanket came over us and we have lots of clouds. Temperatures in the lower 60s with northeasterly winds at 10 miles an hour. And all over the coastal bend, we have the temperatures into the 60s with the exception of Rockport. You're already checking into the upper 50s there. Our water temperature has cooled off to 64 and it's about 60 in Mathis and 61 to 62. For our inland communities. We have an east northeasterly wind, a little brisk near the coastline. Boaters and mariners do use caution out and about, especially if you are on the bays, as they're going about 10 to 20 miles an hour near the coast and 6 to 12 miles an hour for our inland communities. And dew points are still very low. They're dry out there, dry to comfortable with the 40s and 50s. So if you have evening plans for tonight, the farther we go on into the evening, the more opportunity we have for the clouds to come in and the opportunity for some light mist and drizzle to form as well. At 10 o'clock, we'll be into the upper 50s with those northeasterly winds staying pretty elevated, right around 10 to 15 miles an hour. So there the clouds are slowly making their way back up to the north right now at this point, and that's just going to stay with us. We have this second surge of cooler air that's going to be arriving later on for tonight. The primary frontal boundary is still off here in the Gulf of Mexico, still allowing for lots of showers and storms to the southeastern half of the United States. But up here to the north, that's actually snowfall that's falling in the panhandle off in New Mexico as well. And we continue to have a southwesterly flow aloft as this upper level storm system is digging on down into the Four Corners area. So we have cool air at the surface. We have warm air riding on top of that. And so that's going to mean some mist and drizzle for us here. I have a graphic that I'll show you here in just a second. But notice temperatures up to the north. They are brutally cold up there, even for North Texas. 20 degrees in Amarillo, 29 in Lubbock. It's 41 in San Angelo, but just up the road in San Antonio, they're at 56. So as we put the future tracker in motion, going on to tonight, we'll look for the temperatures to continue to drop eventually into the upper 40s, and they really have a hard time recuperating by tomorrow afternoon. Going to be pretty chilly all across the Lone Star State for tomorrow afternoon, and it just continues to stay that way as we go into Sunday morning and on into Sunday afternoon as well. We'll be looking at hard freezes up to the north, and Sunday afternoon, look at that, temperatures really struggle to get out of the 30s for a good portion of the state, and we're going to be struggling to get out of the mid to upper 40s here as we go on into Sunday afternoon. So we're talking about cool air at the surface, warm air aloft. That is an overrunning pattern. So those are the ingredients that we have, the chilly air on the surface, the warm air riding on top of that. So what is the result that we usually see? Well, you're kind of seeing it already. We have the cloud coverage, and eventually it's going to mean showers, it's going to be drizzle, and it's going to be chilly at the surface. So just pretty much a soggy situation for us here as we head on into the weekend. We can see that as we look at our future tracker early in the morning. Again, a couple of spots of the heavier shower activity. Most of this is going to be light mist. That's just going to continue right on into Sunday morning and on into Sunday afternoon. It won't be until Monday that we get a couple of breaks in those clouds. NEC Co-op Energy 7-day forecast. We go to 51 tomorrow, only 49 on Sunday. Chilly, damp, soggy weekend ahead. A little bit more sunshine on New Year's Eve. A secondary frontal boundary comes in early Tuesday. That takes us back into the 50s. Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. We're talking about lows in the upper 30s and highs in the 50s and 60s, Paulo.